Alrighty, Monday night, it is race number 9, the final race of segment 1 for the Perfect Lines Cup Series. The championship's been decided already. We're heading to Richmond. King of Kings already decimated everybody and won the title, which is why he's joining me to call the race tonight. Say hi to the people, King.
Hello, hello. Here in the booth. First time in the booth. It was a good season. Now let's finish it out strong up top. In the booth,
yeah. We got 9 cars on the grid. Aos took the pole handily, and I think he's probably going to dominate because this was his track when the champions lobbies were going on back in the fall.
He had 3/10 on the field when we went to qualifying. Let's see if anyone can have anything for him today.
Well, you say 3/10 on the field, but remember, only 5 cars out of the 9 took time, so.
Yeah, we could have someone from the back surprise us, you know. Yeah. Duke Jr. got a setup. A few good people did not take a time. We'll see what.
I like how you're trying to be like real professional about this. You're trying to sound like an actual commentator. You got my approval.
You got to be professional. It's my first time. Got to make that impression. Yeah.
Now, obviously, because King and I are in a call calling the race, we can't actually listen in on the live chat that these guys are having, but we'll pop in every once in a while if possible. In fact, I just got in time to see the cautions come out for something.
Yeah, it looks like AOS is in the lead. Mr. Bad Aim is in second. And behind that field is we do not know what has happened.
Yeah.
He looks like he has gotten through it pretty well. This might put fuel strategy into the first stage. The first stage is 49 laps with this caution, which should bring that to about 44 to go, 45 to go from here on. And it's about 35 to 40 laps on a tank of fuel, so we'll see.
It looks like Duke Clayton was involved in whatever in the incident. He has damaged the rear end of his car. Both King and Eddie and Razor are already on pit road, which leads me to wonder maybe they've both already dropped out or what the story there is. Unless they came in before the caution, but.
Yeah, looks like we've already had one person drop out. Looks like we have an 8-car field.
We'll have to wait and see whether they go to restart or not. Razor has left already, so we'll see if that was DC or if he left just start and parked it or what he did.
Looks like Eddie just got loose off the corner, came down into Caddy King. Looks like they gather it up. They're gonna wash up the track, and Caddy's gonna drive in for.
Looking back from the race leader, from my view, from Aos running the Hertz scheme, which I think that was Byron's throwback at Darlington last year, wasn't it? Or something? I don't remember. Very weird to see an all-yellow 24 car. I don't know.
Yeah, something about that just does not feel right. You know, you got that rainbow colors.
Yeah, there's no flames. I don't like it.
Yeah, a lot of different colors, man. Looks like the field is getting pretty strung out right about now. The closest battle right now is for fourth, with Eddie hanging on right in front of who was that in the 6th car?
Bad Aim just missed the entry to turn one there. Shot it up the hill, gathered it up though. Well, it's Paco running the 6.
Yeah, Paco. Bad Aim is in the 55.
Paco, the king of running a different car every single week, it seems like.
Yeah, it looks like Eddie might be trying that higher line, or he's just missing the corner, man. Parker's in the 4th, Eddie's dropped back to 5th. Looks like we got Duke Clayton in 6th, we got 36 Symphony in 7th, and who is that running out the back of the field? That might be Symphony in 8th. I might be misspoke. Yeah, it looks like Eddie's getting challenged again. Now he's getting challenged for 5th, really dropping back here after that initial.
Yeah, I think he probably got a good restart, got through all that shuffling. Now he's going to kind of get swallowed back up.
Yeah, it looks like Duke trying to make a move on him, going to the bottom. Eddie running that higher line. It opens up. He's getting inside here. It looks like he's going to complete the pass going into 3. And
Richmond, not one of those tracks where you really want to be running higher, but it's easy to miss your apex both ends of the track. Very much like Iowa, because those two tracks, very similar shapes. You have to turn down just the right point to stick the bottom. If you don't, you're going to wash out and lose a ton of time.
You could easily gain 2 or 3 tenths just by hooking the bottom every single corner, because on the bottom, once you get off the corner, it really helps your car turn off the corner, and you can really get a decent straight shot off the corner as long as your car is not too loose on it.
Of course, the downside of that, much like at Iowa, is that the apron here is basically a sheet of ice. If you overhook the apex, around you go.
Yeah, it looks like AOS is pulling up to a commanding lead over Mr. Bad Aim. We should have about 35 to 30 laps to go on fuel. Who do you think is going to try to save fuel? Do you think anyone's going to try to...
Well, at this point, I mean, if you're not first or second, because Bad Aim has already pulled a pretty good gap over third, if you're not AOS or Bad Aim, I think, you may want to consider it if you think you can do it, because obviously, this being a short track, you're probably going to save some fuel just naturally over the long run. Is it going to be enough, though, to where maybe you can make it and these two can't?
Well, I doubt you can save it naturally. You're going to really have to save fuel amp. The thing is about this track is it really eats tires up. You're going to really want to come to pit road, and by lap 30 to 35 on tires, you're going to really have to play it gentle the first part of the run if you want to really make it stick.
So this is probably going to evolve more into a pit strategy call than a stay out or go or pit call.
Yeah, the right front really wears down hard here. Maybe you can get by at two tires, just take half a can and one can.
Race leader coming up on lap traffic. That I would presume that's got to be Duke Jr., because I can't see Caddy running that badly, but there are two 14 cars out there tonight, so Caddy and Duke Jr., so I would assume that's not Caddy. I can't see him being that bad.
Well, it looks like he has a lot of damage, and either one of them could have gotten to an issue.
This is true, but I would imagine, depending on how bad the damage is, would you have stayed out with that, though?
Yeah, there might have been a shuffle on that restart. Some good damage there onto that 14. Looks like we have a battle right now for 7th place. Looks like Symphony just getting around Eddie for 7th, and that 14 car running at the back already won.
Oh, and just switched to Eddie just in time to, again, show that point. If you just don't turn in at the right point, you just go straight up the hill, and we saw it there with the 20. Trying to stay with the 36, just can't quite hit that apex, and that's what hurts you on these little D ovals here in Iowa, particularly.
Yeah, he really does not have the turn that a lot of the front rows do. Even Symphony, who was complaining about his car turning a lot better through the center and exit of the corner. That's where Eddie is really losing time. He's gonna have to make some major adjustments if he wants to contend for any. Yeah, so at the front, AOS, he looks to have about a 3-second lead on second place. Maybe two and a half second lead on Mr. Bad Aim.
Yeah, Bad Aim, who has about a similar gap back to third place. I assume that's... Yeah, Caddy... I'm assuming that's Caddy in the 14 that's not beat up. Along with Paco and Duke Clayton trying to stay with him. That's... third, fourth, and fifth, and they're a ways back of the leaders. We definitely have two dominant cars in this field.
Yeah, and you have to keep in mind, Mr. Bad Aim had to start at the back. He did not qualify, so he might have a pretty good car able to challenge AOS. He just had to get through the pack, and that might be the result of the gap. So who knows?
Well, and and AOS just lagged a bunch there. For a sec there, I thought the caution was about to come out, and then AOS's car just, like, surged, wobbled, and back he went. That could have been me, though. Hard to say.
Yeah, so pit road speed here is 45 miles per hour. Is it 45 or is it 40 miles an hour? Either way, you're going to want to slow down once you come into turn three and four. You're going to want to slow down halfway on the dotted line. Now, this pit road entry is pretty forgiving, given that in NASCAR Heat 3 in this game, you can turn in after the cone here. So if you are going to miss pit road, as long as you get it slowed down enough, it will not count you as speeding, and you will be able to enter pit road after the cone. Now, does anyone else know this? Will anyone else be able to take advantage of this? That is the question.
So the actual point at which it registers you as being on pit road is not at the cone. It's actually at the first white line.
Because
the cone's like the yellow line and the cone's right in the middle of three and four.
Yeah, but you can enter much later than that. I think you can enter all the way up to the barrels. You can enter anytime you
want. We'll have to see whether or not that falls in anybody's lap here as we go along.
Yeah, I really shouldn't be giving away some of my secrets.
The trade secrets.
The trade secrets, we'll see what they do for Heat 4. They've got to really fix that during pit road. They got to fix a lot of things. They got to add qualifying. They got to fix pit road entry. They got to fix a lot. And with the spectating thing, they got to give names. They got to
live timing and scoring.
Exactly.
So I don't have to guess who's where.
Looks like we're going to be coming to green flag pit stops in maybe 15 to 20 laps. We'll see who comes down pit road, who tries to strike. You think anyone will split the difference, take four tires halfway?
I don't know. I feel like if they were going to...
Mr. Bad Aim is in the wall in turns one and two.
I think he because I'm on board with him. He went wide in one and two, but he didn't hit anything.
No, it was Duke. Duke hit the wall in turns one and two.
I was gonna say.
I think he might have had an issue with the six. I'm not 100% sure. It looks like he and the six might have got together in turns one and two. If you look at that 28 car, the nose is completely destroyed. He might want to come to pit road as soon as he can, because...
It's a little wrinkled and scuffed on my screen, but... Doesn't seem like it's...
Is the connection a little wonky for you, or...?
No, the inbound connection seems alright. Like I said, AOS... had a spot of lag there while I was watching him a little bit ago, but everybody seems to be stable on my screen, so...
No, I'm talking about voice. Are you picking me up already?
Well, I'm picking you up fine. If anything, you're probably not picking me up perfectly.
You know, why don't you drop in their channel, listen and get a lap count, and I will try to sort out my...
All right, I'll be back then.
Turn it now. Pit. Pitting. Black flag, dang it.
Race leader, can I get a lap check? 12 to go? I think we got about 10 to go this time-ish. I think that's what when I asked AOS, he said 12, and then I think he said 12. So we should be right around 10 to go here.
Yeah, so Duke Clayton, has made his way into pit road. Looks like he's going to get that damage repaired. Eddie is also in the pit lane right now. He's coming out.
Yeah, when I jumped over, someone came on the pit road and got busted. Someone got black flagged. I I couldn't tell exactly which one. I think it may have been Duke Jr., but...
Yeah, it looks like the 14 is stuck. Yeah, he's coming out of pit road.
Yeah,
right,
so...
Now. Looks like Duke Jr.
He took a took the old speeding penalty.
Yeah, he's still in his box all of this time being lost. Or did he disconnect?
A lot of cars on pit road. Race leader still has not come in. So, yeah, I wonder if Aos perhaps is at least going to take this as far as he can.
Yeah, we have the 6 coming in this time, 36 finishing their stop, exiting pit road. Yeah, we'll see what happens.
Aos still going.
Yep. He might be stretching that fuel. We'll see what happens. And, yeah, it looks like the other 14 might have disconnected. He's still in his box.
Hmm.
And yeah, looks
nope, leader's in.
Yep. Looks to be Duke Jr. as he has left the call. Yeah, Aos just hit pit road, so did Caddy right behind him.
Jump on. Jumping on board with Bad Aim to see where he cycles out.
Yeah, it looks like he would be.
Common sense would say he should gain some ground here off the short pit, but doubtful that it would be enough.
Let's see if Aos takes 2 tires here. Looks like 1 Mississippi, 2. Looks like, yep, that looks like fuel only. That looks like a fuel only call.
Interesting call for the race leader. Fuel only. I suppose if you've only got 5 or 6 laps to go, you could potentially, if the car's driving all right, you could risk it. He does come back out.
Yeah,
Bad Aim is within sight of him. We'll have to see.
He either made up a lot of time on tires, or he also did the same strategy as AOF. We will see if he gains time in these next few laps, so I don't know if he has time to run him down.
And there is, looks like lap traffic could be an issue depending on how many laps there are left. Oh, car in the wall, turn 4.
It looks like they both negotiated all right.
That was, I believe.
I can't tell if Bad Aim is catching up to AOS. It looks like he might.
He might be a little bit. Again, I don't know if he has time, though. If he only took 2 tires, it's not going to be as huge a benefit as it potentially.
And hey, he's within about a second here. He might be able to catch, depending on how many laps. I'm looking. I'm guessing.
And car in the wall, turn 1. But that might have been Eddie.
He's very close. He's within 3/4 of a second here. I give it 2 to 3 more laps before that.
Yeah.
Gets
if
back.
If they have that long.
Looks like they both get by Eddie, all right?
That oh, yeah. Bad Aim's catching him fast.
Oh, yeah.
But
if they got 1 more to go,
yeah,
any more than 1 more lap after this, then...
Oh, yeah. If this isn't the stage, then Aos is done for. And they got another lap, so... Aos is going to have to run defensive here.
Yeah, come down.
Oh, look at that diamond in the corner. He's there. For the stage win.
Aos drives it in way...
Oh, that was not going to work. You can't work the outside like that.
And he's going to have it. We got a few more laps, but it looks like Bad Aim is going to take the stage here.
Oh, yeah. Aos made a huge... Yeah, he's dropping way off. In fact... Oh, wait. Wait a minute. They all slowed down. But I wonder if Bad Aim was actually a lap down. Because they slowed way down. I think actually Bad Aim got himself back on the lead lap, what he did.
Yeah, you might be right there.
So he might have... Maybe he took 4 tires... And that cost him a lap doing it. Maybe he got penalized or something. I'm going to jump over and find out.
Yeah, check the scoring.
Can I get a scoring check, please, gentlemen?
For the stage?
Yes.
Me, Caddy, Symphony, Paco, and then Bad Aim.
Okay. Because this whole time, we thought Bad Aim was chasing you down for the race lead. I didn't realize. It wasn't until I looked back and saw you slowing way down. I was like, oh, wait a minute. He just got himself back in the lead laps, what he did.
Yeah.
All right. Good thing I checked then.
Yeah.
All right, so I can confirm Aos did win stage one. What we thought was a great battle for the lead actually was just a battle to get back on the lead lap. So.
Hey, a battle nonetheless. Here we go with the restart of stage two. Caddy on the outside. Let's see if he has anything for Aos going into turn one and two. Looks like he does not. He drops off a few car lengths instantly. Symphony's going to come back into the backstretch, looking on the inside, but he's not going to have position.
This is where we're going to see what Bad Aim has on equal tires. You have to assume they all pitted again under this caution.
Yeah, it looks like he's made his way up to fourth. He's going to be challenging Symphony here, looking on the top.
That's not a smart move. Now Paco's in there.
Ooh, look at that.
They got away with it.
Even the racing here back in the pack, you got to get everything you can. Bad Aim working the top, trying to get away from Paco. He does have a fast car, but he just has to make up the ground that he's lost. Maybe he sped on pit road there.
That must have been it, because he was second coming into pit stops. Yeah, you wouldn't have lost a lap on four tires. So,
I mean, keep in mind it is a 20-ish second pit stop, 20 to 21 second stop. Aos, if he just took half a can, he gained 12 seconds. That might have been enough if Bad Aim really got a bad pit entry or exit. I don't know if he got a penalty there.
Ooh, a little loose off two, though. Yeah, they're all over each other back there in the pack. Aos and Caddy getting away from this.
If it looks like Bad Aim is going to clear for third with Paco right behind it. Looks like we got the other black car, Duke Clayton, in a fifth right now.
And then Eddie sixth, Symphony seventh. Those are the last two cars running.
Yeah, it looks like Bad Aim is making a pretty good time. He might be catching Caddy for second here, but I think Aos is long gone. He has at least 2 to 3 seconds over the rest of the field.
Definitely the car to beat, that 24 car.
Yeah, they might have to do some strategy unless Mr. Bad Aim and or Caddy can really improve their car here. It looks like Paco also has a pretty alright car. He's keeping with Mr. Bad Aim pretty good. If not, maybe even a better. Both of them have a better car than Caddy here.
Because Bad Aim's gaining on Caddy. He's bringing Paco right along with him. Oh, but Paco hit the apron. He might have. I think he tripped pit road. He's in. I don't think he meant to do that.
He hit the cone. Yeah. Very unfortunate set of events. He had a great car.
That said, though. Did they complete enough laps where maybe he could now make it on fuel to at least maybe not go a lap down?
Yeah, it is 47 laps in this run, and it's 35 to 40 laps of fuel that you get on a stop. So
that's good.
I think we ran about 10 laps, so I think he's good. As long as he runs very competitively here, he might be able to salvage a lead lap finish at the end of the stage here. Yeah, considering that we got the caution in stage one and they still were not able to save enough fuel to make it to the end of the stage, I doubt that anyone will try to make it all the way to the end. Looks like Bad Aim got the wall off.
It was definitely close.
Actually, it looks like we're going to have a battle for fourth here. It looks like Paco is getting challenged by...
Well, that's not for four. That's... Paco's a lap down, remember?
Oh, what? So, can you update the scoring for me?
So you got Aos leading, Caddy second, Bad Aim third, Duke fourth. And it looks like it's Symphony ahead of Eddie, assuming they're both on the same lap. Again, timing and scoring. I wish we had it.
Well, either way, looks like Duke is going to get around Paco. And
yeah.
Duke can set his sights on Mr. Bad Aim. Let's see if he can make up any time. Mr. Bad Aim is not caught up to Caddy the way we thought. It looks like he might be dropping off a little bit. Is really balanced out between 1 second and a second and a half here.
Well, just being on board, Bad Aim, he is driving it in deep. It doesn't sound like he doesn't really start getting off the gas, so he's already turning down into the corner. Now, again, that could just be the game telling me things that aren't true, but...
No. I've some of your footage, and throttle that you're hearing is pretty accurate. So when you hear them get it on the throttle, if you can get on the throttle early here and keep it in the gas, that's what you're going to want here. You're going to want to listen into Alyssa's throttle to see how well he can get into the throttle coming off the corner.
Yeah, he's kind of, now that he's out in front, he's taking it easy. He's getting off of it. Like, going into turn one, the first lane marker, ditto in three and four, whereas Bad Aim's really driving it in. He's not getting really on the brakes till about the third set of lane markers there. Like, one, two, brake, kind of a. So he's driving a lot harder. It also sounds like Aos is running a different gear. He's running a much lower RPM gear than Bad Aim is.
Yeah, maybe keeping fuel mileage into question. You know, he likes that low gear. He's been pretty good with fuel mileage throughout the season. So let's see if that's a play for later in the race. Remember, the last stage is 100 laps. So I'm guessing he's going to try to freestop it. It might be a freestop for everyone here, but him especially, he's got the fuel mileage to do it.
Yeah, because that would put it to a two-stop third stage if you're looking at 40 laps a run. So if he can get it to 45, he could probably get away with a splash and go or two tires or whatever he wanted to do. Whereas people who can only go 40 and are going to have to pit with 20 to go are suddenly going to have to probably take tires. So
yeah, so the strategy is you're either going to want to split it evenly. So 33 laps, pit at lap 33, pit at lap 66, and then that'll be the end of the stage. You'll do 33 laps a run. Or what you can do is you could stretch it as long as you could. So let's say 40 laps in each stint. And then at the end, just do a two tire, one cam. Stop. We'll have to see what they do here. But right now, stage two is winding down. ALS has a commanding lead, but they will have to come into pit stops within the next 10 laps or so. Looks like Eddie is already coming to pit row.
Oop, Bad Aim catching the wall off two a little bit that time. He has closed back up on Caddy for second place.
Yeah, it looks like he has a better long-run car than Caddy. He was pretty decently into the run here, and he's starting to make gains again. He started gaining on the short run, but it really leveled off for a good while there. He's really getting wide off the corner, maybe a little bit loose off. He's really pushing here.
Yeah, King, meanwhile, is absolutely checked out. Give you an idea here. Oh, speaking of the leader, he's on pit road now.
Did he just say King is absolutely checked out?
I meant to say Aos, but whatever. Hey, look, you already checked out in the championship. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
Point being, race leader's on pit road.
I think he might go for more of a traditional two-tire call. I don't think he liked how much it dropped off later on. Maybe he's worried about tire. We'll see how long he stays in his box here.
With as big a lead as he had.
Looks like it's four tires. Unless he sped, though. He's in for at least 13, now 15. Yeah, he might have sped coming off. I don't know. It's either
he did catch the when I cut to him coming in, he did catch the inside wall. So I wonder perhaps if the car got sideways on him on the apron and the game detected him speeding. Because that has happened before. We'll have to see.
That either does. Way, he had about 15 to 20 second pit stop. Now this could be opportunity for either Caddy or Duke Clayton to gain on him. Not Duke Clinton, I'm sorry, Mr. Batting. Depending on whether he sped on pit road or could they take two tires, try to make up some time. Now, this is an opposite strategy as to what AOS did last time, so we'll see how it works out.
The bad aim is to the bottom. I think he may be in this time. Yes, he is.
That looks like a pretty damn good entry, unless he sped there. It looks like he got slowed down really late, carried a lot of... Looks like a very good entry. K Caddy looks to be staying out on the track a little bit longer here, maybe playing either the fuel mileage in, or he's going to go in for two tires or maybe just a splash later on, try to make up some.
As far behind as they were a good probably 8 or 9 seconds back by the time when AOS came in, so any strategy call is going to be a good one, I suppose.
Did he catch how long Bad Name stayed in the pits? I think that might have been too tired.
Yeah, he's just left now, so he had just gotten to his box when Caddy went by the first time. He's just catching him now.
Yeah, he's still about 8 seconds back of AOS. That might have been a similar strategy, probably four tires as well. Let's see if Caddy can do anything with it. Let's see if he goes for a strategy call, because he is staying pretty late out. He still has not come to...
He's actually going to pass Bad Aim, which is surprising.
Did he come to pit road while we were not paying attention? Or?
I don't think so, because I was with Bad Aim for a good while there, and yeah, Bad Aim was the first of the two to break off.
Yeah, maybe he's got to get some heat in those tires, you know. Now he seems to be heating up. He seems to be all over him right now.
Yeah.
Maybe Caddy just got that really good long-run car, you know.
Well, as tends to be in this game with loose setups, you set yourself up loose, you're going to be really loose the first couple of laps. Now Bad Aim gets the run to the inside. We should get him back. This will put him back to one lap down at the moment. Of course, he'll get the other one back when Caddy pits.
Yeah, Caddy does not look like he's fighting in there. He's probably on old tires. He's running up top. He's running all over the place, getting whatever... last bit of grip he can out of these tires. Yeah, he's really falling. Have you done any crank it ups in the booth?
Well, it's kind of hard to. I mean, I suppose I can just cut to... if I switch to, like... TV cam, but even then, there's no like speed shots really. So, and the audio from the TV cam isn't very good either.
Yeah. So. You could raise up the volume, join their channel, raise up the radio communications. I think.
Yeah, 704. You want to get on that? Give us all that stuff for Heat 4.
Yeah. Where's the crank it up? That's the
where's the yeah? I want for Christmas is a crank it up button. I don't care if Fox owns the trademarks to it.
Yeah, it looks like Symphony just pit much later than AOS and Caddy.
I mean, at this point, Caddy's only strategy is hoping for a caution to trap AOS a lap down. I mean that.
Yeah, it looks like Symphony might have took two tires, maybe even no tires, but that's not... at this point, he's probably just trying to stay on the lead lap with some...
And the Caddy's coming now. Yep, there he goes.
I think it's going to be fuel only for Caddy here.
He's it almost has to be, because there goes AOS. That's going to get him back on... that's AOS getting his lap back. He can't afford to be on pit road very long if he wants to try to get out of... even close, as AOS puts Paco a lap down.
At this point, he might just be trying out strategies, seeing how his car handles, because he has had a pretty good long-run car even past Mr. Bad Aim on the short run. Even after.
And there goes AOS for the lead.
Yeah, it looked like two tires to me.
People not that it was really going to matter, but...
tires, but... yeah, unless you make an adjustment, he's going to be pretty loose here. Where is he going to cycle out with Bad Aim? Because they were pretty close on the track before the stop.
Actually, it looks like AOS gained a good bit of time. It's not AOS. Caddy gained a good bit of time there. Ooh, and that didn't help. Bad Aim hit the apron in three. Is all out of shape. That didn't help his...
actually in danger of going a lap down. He's already made up his lap back from earlier in the race, but... leader is only about a quarter of a lap behind. He's on the same straightaway, so we'll see. He's probably going to be able to hold on with virtue of not being a lot of laps left in the state. That's yeah. concerning.
But AOS has absolutely put a spanking on them. Give you a time check. AOS is at the line now. Caddy is about a half a lap behind. And I'm presuming the Caddy's in second place still. Caddy is at the line now. So.
Yeah, so they're going to have to do some crazy strategy here at the end. Maybe if we get a caution within about 10 laps of starting the stage, that can put some fuel strategy into question, because that would break the last stage into about 45 laps apiece, which, if they save, they might be able to do maybe 40 laps.
Ooh,
I know
Duke
that's
Clayton.
Pushing it, especially with the high tire wear, but we'll see what happens.
Duke Clayton drops a lap to the leader, hitting the wall off turn two.
Looks like AOS definitely has the car, unless he makes a huge error, because it's gonna be a two. As long as we don't get a caution in the last stage, it's gonna be a two-stop race for everyone. That's not gonna be a lot of room for strategy, because you're gonna have to break it either on 33 each, or you're gonna have to break it 40, 40, and 20. Either way, it's gonna be about the same time. We'll see if anyone can make their car good enough to challenge AOS and or. Do some miracle strategy.
Paco back on pit road, so evidently was not able to make it from that unscheduled stop at the start of the stage. That's probably going to cost him two laps in the process.
Yeah, I'd be lucky. I'd be lucky if I was only two laps on if I were him. He's really made a huge error there with that.
And AOS takes the stage.
Looks like it's going to be Caddy for second. And maybe Mr. Bad Aim hanging on for the last car in the lead lap. You're going to want to go for a scoring update.
Indeed, because this got all over the place. BRB.
Waiting for you.
Oh, were you? Hey, Austin, can you please stop kicking everybody's ass? It's getting really boring. So, obviously, you won that stage decisively.
It's Caddy, Bad Aim, Symphony, and then Duke Clayton.
Yeah. Can we try to make this kind of interesting? You know, winning a stage by half a lap is not very interesting. I'm just saying.
Well, you still let King race.
I didn't tell him he couldn't. He chose not to. Yeah, so we were right. So King, then Caddy, then Bad Aim, then Symphony.
Duke got into pit road at the end of the stage, which is legal in this league, so he probably did get a lap back here.
Well, he was a lap down, so you are permitted to pit on the last lap if you are a lap down.
Let's see if they have anything for AOS on this restart.
This
bad
is the
peeking on the inside.
Yeah, I was about to say this is the closest Bad Aim's been to the leader on a start at this point. So
AOS really diving in deep, trying to establish that early lead. Bad Aim is just not able to clear Caddy King. Hopefully, he can get clear here. That's what he wants.
So, yeah,
he's going to be able to clear.
Caddy not good on that high line.
Yeah, he really needs to focus down here, really nail his laps, because AOS really has a good short run car. Because by the time that they even out, even like close to evening out, he just already checked out. Looks like he did hold serve pretty good here.
Well, I was ooh in there. First, Paco caught the apron in one and two, and then it looked like Eddie got loose off two. Just about lost it on the backstretch. Managed to gather it up though.
Yeah, it looks like Bad Aim has probably made some improvement. Oh, Caddy just got the wall off, too. He's probably going to be out of the lead race for now, at least. But Bad Aim definitely has a pretty good car here in the 55. Running that second lane off the track hasn't really been used here. Pretty unconventional. But he is making it work. Looks like he's losing a little bit of time here. Probably wants to run the bottom, but he might just be a little bit either too tight or too loose to run the bottom. I know it really rotates you coming off the corner here. So he might be having to run the top just to keep it straight on, but he is keeping about a 3/10. Oh, we just got loose.
Yeah, that. Yeah, he's definitely loose on exit. Ooh, and that's the apron, and he clipped the cone.
That's the mistake. He's just clipped the cone. He's out of it. He's completely fucking ruined himself here. Looks like that's just the break AOS needed to check out.
Yeah, that's gonna probably seal the deal there.
Very, very doubtful that
Bad Aim can make it on one stop from here.
Yeah, Caddy, Mr. Bad Aim needs cautions. He needs cautions. He needs to get on the lead lap. He needs to stretch fuel. He needs to do anything he can to make up time. But I think that almost certainly has sealed the deal. With Caddy from already about a straightaway behind, about half a straightaway behind, and about 2 to 3 seconds behind, it might be over here.
Yeah, Bad Aim.
We had a decent battle back in the pack right behind Caddy King. Looks like 3rd through 6th here. But yeah, with Caddy King on last car on the lead lap, Duke making his way up. Actually, no, Duke being the last car on the lead lap in 4th. And then we got Symphony in 5th, I think, 1 lap down. And Paco might be 2 down. Oh, looks like there's the move. Duke trying not to waste any time getting around Paco in the apron. Duke trying to catch up to Caddy for 2nd right here. Paco still trapped behind Symphony. Must be pretty frustrated with a decent car, even able to keep up with Mr. Bad Aim on a decent run here. Must be frustrating to be a lap down or even multiple laps.
And in Bad Aim's case, bad story gets even worse, and you realize not only did he trip the cone, of course, that also meant he got penalized for being too fast, so he lost 2 laps in the process. Actually, well over 2 laps.
So it looks like the closest battle on the track is going to be for 2nd. Duke Clayton has made some pretty good adjustments to his car. He's catching up on Caddy King. Now, maybe if we get a restart here, he might be able to challenge AOS, but that's pretty unlikely.
And I think Bad Aim has left because he's back on pit road. So he may have rage quit over that whole deal. I'm not sure. Either that or he came back in. His front end of his car is all beat up, so he may have also wrecked it or something.
Meanwhile, we got a pretty good battle for 2nd here. Duke Clayton just looked inside Caddy, but Caddy might have not known he was there. He came down on Duke. He hit the apron, but he gathered it up. Right now, trying to reel back in Caddy King. 2nd and 3rd right on each other. Duke really dives it in there pretty good, but Caddy's hooked.
I can confirm Bad Aim has left. He's left the call, so it's a horrible break for him. As we really now focus on the only battle that's of any kind of meaning whatsoever, Caddy and Duke for 2nd place.
Well, it looks like Paco might be faster than both of them, trying to get around them, but knowing that they're lead lap cars, he probably does not want to get in there and be too aggressive there. But
he's
hit the apron. Big mistake by Duke Clayton there, losing a lot of time and possibly touch of 2nd place here. He's going to need to really focus down here because he does have a quick car. He did reel in Caddy King from about a 2nd back, but he's lost all that time and more now, so he's got quite a job ahead of him. Yeah, Paco definitely closing on Caddy, maybe even bringing Duke with him, but it's hard to assess at this moment. Paco going to be wanting to get by Caddy King here, though I don't know if he's going to be able to catch AOS for to manually unlap himself, but hey, he's running for a pride at this point.
Oh, no chance in hell of unlapping himself.
Oh, Paco's hit the apron, Duke Clayton has hit the apron, they're all hitting the apron, making mistakes. Clayton now about 4 seconds back to Caddy King. We're about 5 laps ago. He's right on his bumper. Even Symphony, which is multiple laps down, is by Duke Clayton. Must be furious at this.
And AOS, meanwhile, has absolutely checked out. He's already closing in on half a lap lead over Caddy. course, now that he's out there by himself, he can just run his line. Doesn't have to worry about watching his mirrors. He can just do his thing.
Now, do you think he's enjoying this Sunday drive with me gone? Or do you think he's missing that challenge? What do you think is going through his head right now?
Well, I'll tell you, when I jumped into the call, I basically I challenged them and said, hey, can you please make this interesting? Because it's kind of boring watching AOS win stages by half a lap. And AOS just said, well, King should have raced then. I was like, he chose not to.
I mean, hey, it might have been the same thing. I might have been half a lap ahead of him. It might have been the same thing, except worse.
Or you...
At least this Mr. Bad Aim was close, you know? We could have had a race.
Or you would have just continued to infuriate Symphony about how good you are at qualifying with a setup you just threw in.
Meanwhile,
I spent 7 hours on my setup. He puts it in 5 minutes before qualifying and fastest car on the track.
I mean, a lot of this is being able to work with what you have. Some people's driving style, they have to have the car working exactly how they want. They can't be loose on exit. They have to turn this specific way. They have to be able to get in throttle. Here, you know, part of what I'm able to do is I can make even a bad setup, I can make it work. I can, even if it's tight, if it's loose, I can make adjustments on pit stops, and I can get it at least drivable. You know, I can get it to where I want throughout the race. That's part of what NASCAR is. You gotta make, even if you don't got the best car, you can still make things happen. Meanwhile, Paco still stalking the second place car of Caddy. Paco being at least a lap down. He's hit the wall of turn two.
Duke just hit the wall in turn two, yeah.
Yeah, it looks like turn two is definitely the trouble spot here. A lot of people getting either loose off the corner, just trying to hold the throttle way too. A lot of ground loss here. That and the commitment cone in turns three and four. That looks like Eddie going another lap down. What are we, five down now? Somewhere?
I don't even know.
Yeah, not going to fight him. Just runs the high line. AOS has already checked out on that. Not wanting to get caught up in anyone else's. Yep. How many cars do you think we have in the lead lap at the end of this?
Well, at the rate AOS is going, he might lap everybody. He's already got about almost a half a lap on Caddy, so I mean...
Yeah, let's say one or two. two if AOS makes a mistake. I think AOS could probably speed on pit road both times and still win this race.
I don't know about that, because, I mean, that's 30 seconds of penalties right there. That's a lap plus, but...
But you have to keep in mind here that we've only run about 25 laps. They haven't even made their first pit stop yet, and Caddy's already half a lap down.
Yes, but that being said, it has sort of stabilized a bit. It's not as massive.
A car that just slammed the wall on the backstretch. Eddie just nailed it off to his car. He just ran high in the corners. It looks fine, but looks to be deceiving, especially in this game.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, he's way...
Oops, Symphony has looped it off turn two. Gets it pointing the right way.
It looks like Duke Clayton letting by the leader, as you do when you make a mistake in your cars. Paco still having that spirited battle with Caddy, still trying to catch up.
It may not even be on the same lap, but doesn't care.
Definitely not in the same lap. He's lost way too much time in that stage two mistake there. Having to put in extra time is probably one.
Caddy is starting to gap him, though, so.
You say that, but he just makes mistakes. He catches up for a few laps, and then he makes another mistake. That's what he got. He has to iron out. Like, he's shown speed a lot of times this year, but he makes a few mistakes here and there, so. Got to iron those out for next season.
Of course, in 2 weeks' time, segment two of the Cup schedule begins at Talladega. Oh, boy. And word from the Xfinity garage was a little bit of controversy last night. towards the finish of the Xfinity race at Talladega, as you would expect from Talladega. Of course, there'd be controversy, but
yeah. So at the end of the Talladega race, I sped on pit road after getting a little nudge, and the lead pack was Miss You, Caddy, and AOS. Now, as I was going for the championship, and I needed, if Caddy won the race, he won the championship. And as long as he didn't win the race, it would either tie or I would win the championship. So I was encouraging Monsieur to drive aggressively, keep the lead, protect it from Caddy. And what do you know? They had a little scuff in turns three, trying to go a little bit too low entering the corner. So we'll see how they rule on that, but I don't want to get into that, keep it out of the booth.
No, exactly.
Let's just say I'm not too happy with it being a little controversial.
Understandable, but they've only got a couple more hours to file their any penalty reports for Xfinity. Nothing's been posted as of this moment, so it looks like it may be all said and done unless Caddy or somebody comes forward and says there should be something called, but we'll see how that all plays out. If things don't change between now and then, looks like you're going to be a triple champion this segment. Dirt, along with Xfinity and Cup.
Yeah, it looks like we have green flag pit stops starting here. Eddie just came in pit road for 4 fresh tires. Paco is also in this lap.
Yeah.
We should expect to see the leaders in a few laps here. But some might try to stretch it longer than others.
Well, I know AOS has already been in. I saw him come in while we were talking about Talladega. So at this point, Caddy is the on-track leader. Although, I think he's coming in now. Yes, he is.
Yeah, it looks like a pretty damn conservative venture there.
Well, I think after seeing so many people trip the cone and get busted speeding, I don't think he was taking any chances.
I mean, you gotta admit, after this race being dominated by AOS, he must be pretty demoralized. You're not even trying to push pit entry as much as he might normally. I mean, just the moral of the whole field is down. Thinking I'm gone and this is their chance to shine.
And AOS shows up and kicks their asses.
I mean, hey, someone had to follow in my footsteps,
I suppose. But see, in your cases, all the races you've won, you just sort of show up with 20 to go and suddenly you're the leader. You haven't really had a statement race like this one where you just show up and just destroy everybody.
Yeah, I think I have earlier in the season, but that was back before this whole commentating thing started up. And especially in some of the lower steers, I have a lot of races like this. But in Cup, usually what happens is I run pretty conservative, stay on the lead lap, only really show up for stage finishes and the race, because it's not really about leading every lap here, because a lot of these races, it's about a lot of people ended up in incidents, so you got to run. I usually run pretty conservatively, trying to take care of my stuff. And it's only the finish, it's the finish that counts, it's the stages and it's the race finish. You don't got to lead every lap.
Well, you mentioned Caddy's pit entry was a little conservative, and it's definitely showing because AOS is about. Well, let's give you a. Caddy's at the line now, and AOS is at the line now, so.
Yeah, he is absolutely going to be at least one lap down before the end of the stage.
Yeah, if this goes green the rest of the way, this is AOS's race to win, and it's also his race to lose if he chooses to throw it away somehow.
Yeah, Duke is in pit road here. He's already gone one lap down. So, yeah, Caddy's the last guy on the lead lap besides AOS. Looks like a clean victory coming.
Knock on wood.
Looks like the leader's going to have some traffic here.
Yeah, you got Eddie and Paco ahead.
Yeah, it looks like Duke also joining right behind. might be fresher tires to outgive the catch the leaders. He is one lap down, so he might try to lap himself here.
Yeah, well, he just scuffed the wall off turn four, so I wouldn't worry about Duke.
I mean, hey, I know one person isn't worried, and that's that guy, and that hurts 24.
Yeah. I said it was yellow earlier. Might as well be gold for how well he's running.
So, Bud, when are you going to come out of retirement? When are you getting that new router?
Yeah. no comment.
you like it more comfy in the booth?
I wouldn't necessarily say that, but just I'm not going to rush to fix something that I have no power in fixing. So.
Yeah, I got you. Well, it looks like leader moves cleanly by Eddie, putting him another lap down. Drink every time you hear that.
Yeah, but take it's just drinking game. Take a shot every time AOS laps somebody.
You'd be plastered. You'd be in the emergency room with your stomach pumped.
That's right. If we did that for every time you won a race, we'd all be dead by now.
Yeah, it looks like Caddy is slowly being reeled in here. It's less than a straightaway easily. He's running on the top, trying to find any speed he can, but there is no stopping that point. Looks like Paco is gonna go another lap down as well as Caddy. Look, they still have that spirited battle, man. They've been together ever since it started.
These cars are freaking magnetized at this point.
Yeah, you always find those two cars in the race that always seem to be running near each other, whether it's an incident or they're just racing each other green flag stops throughout the race. There's always those two cars that just can't seem to get away from each other. Like Paco might be trying to make the move, knowing that the leader's coming, trying to gain all the time that he can.
As we said earlier, Paco's got a pretty good short run car. He can run with these guys for a while. At this point, it's probably just delaying the inevitable. He's going to get lapped again.
And hey, are these guys going to fight the leader, try to keep the laps? Maybe they get into an incident. Maybe that opens up the race. We'll see what happens. Looks like Paco trying to make the move to get by Caddy, try to preserve all the time he can, not wanting to get hung up behind that slower car, albeit on the lead. And that's going to be clear. Caddy falling into the clutches of AOS. Less than a second separates them. Maybe a little more, but around a second. As I said, he closes even more. It's hard to even.
Yeah, this is the kind of butt kicking I was expecting to see Symphony give at Texas, and we didn't get that, so.
Ooh, looks like Caddy almost clipping the cone. He's been pretty consistent throughout the race, but. Getting a little weary. It's a long, long race.
I was going to say, you say clipping the cone, more like clipping where the cone used to be. It has now, I believe, been punted somewhere to the other side of Virginia.
Oh, looks like we got a car on the wall. Looks like Eddie just in front of the leaders. I think he's able to gather it up. But it looks like if Eddie falls back at a decent pace, we might have three cars pretty damn close together with the leader.
I was about to say, Eddie must be having some big problems because they just lapped him not that long ago. But here we go to lap the field. Naos has got the nose in, and Caddy's going to let him go. Not even going to fight it.
So AOS has lapped the field.
Is there a mercy rule? Can we just call the race now?
I mean, hey, you got to say, at least when I win, I show up at the end and make it interesting. Do something crazy. Either I race my way in there or do some strategy. At least it's interesting.
Whereas... I suppose there was still Martinsville though. Martinsville was just sort of, you got the lead and it was over.
Yeah.
But
Martinsville, it was one of these type races. Although I did get into an incident pretty early in the race that kept me back in traffic, which was pretty good for TV.
I know. It made the first two stages really great, and then you got out front in stage three, and it was just like, yeah, it's over.
See, the more I'm around cars, the more interesting things are. And then when I'm out of the race, it just goes flat out the whole race.
I'll just remember, in 2 weeks' time, it's Talladega. It's anybody's race.
See, I can't say I'm a good plate racer, but hey, I ran all right last night, got the pole, so maybe I am. I don't know. The thing is, it's just the setup. So, looks like we got five cars under blanket coming into one and two here. We might get a little congestion here. Duke running the top, Caddy trying to go by, not for position.
Let's see, yeah, Duke well off the pace though. So he's not even.
Yeah,
gonna try to hold them up.
Yeah, Paco's still in front of the leader here. Might be the one guy who might try to fight, because he might still be one lap down here. And being one and two laps down, that might be the difference between being able to salvage your race. There's about one car lane separating the two as they go into one and two. AOS trying to arc the corner, entering a lot higher than Paco, but Paco's keeping some decent.
Leader's making his second stop.
That looked like a very aggressive pit entry here. He probably could have been a little bit more conservative, but what's to lose?
Yeah, even with the penalty, he'd still be like 5 seconds, 5 or 10 seconds ahead. Jeez.
Like he's coming in for a routine pit stop. Looks like it's going to be four tires and fuel. It should be around 30 to go here, if I've predicted right. Maybe 30 to 40 to go here, so this is going to be the last stint, the last pit stop in this. I doubt anyone will be able to stretch it to make it on one stop. The thing is, the longer they go, maybe they can do two tires, but that's not going to make the difference. AOS has this in the bag, as long as he does not get caught up in the incident.
Yeah, he's got about a straightaway ahead of Caddy, which would put him one lap down, which gives you an idea. He's still on the lead lap, and he made a pit stop at a short track.
I mean, can you call this a short track? I mean, it's pretty big. You get pretty fast here, about 150 going into the corner. It's one of those wide, short-ish tracks that kind of fall in the middle. I know NASCAR qualifies it as a short track, but there's a lot of space. Aero plays a big role. And you don't normally see too much of the bumping.
Well, if you ask Carl Edwards and Kyle Busch, the old dump and run.
Yeah, you always, and there's always those people who do it wherever you go. You can dump it wherever you want. Isn't this exactly how you want to spend your Monday?
Couldn't think of a better way.
Winding down the laps towards the end here. Not too much to comment, unfortunately.
Yeah.
down and another lap down. And you're just simply had a pretty horrid race here. So an update on what happened with Duke. Left the race with engine damage and the setup was not the best. He's actually interested in coming in for an interview. Why don't we ask him some questions about the track?
You are right. Give us something to talk about. Go for it.
Yeah, give us something to talk about, you know. See if he hops in here.
Hello.
Welcome to the booth. So how were those fucking conditions today, man? It looks like everyone's loose off the two.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. I got taken out pretty quick because I had put the setup into the Xfinity car because I was misled. By the picture, so
yeah.
Kind of out there with the default custom setup. Still though, it wasn't great. That coming out of the corner, coming off a two, there's that hump, and it's like you drop off into off a cliff, you know.
Yeah, you gotta be a little bit tighter off the corner.
Yeah.
If you wanna be able to, it rotates yourself.
Yeah, so, yeah, but yeah. If you're a little bit loose, it's gonna send you right around. So that's
yeah.
That's what they're dealing with out there.
Well, it looks like AOS is checked out on the field here.
Yeah, he's.
Did you see anyone at any point in the race that could challenge?
I mean, well, when I was getting passed by the entire field, I was kind of able to see a little bit. I mean. I don't know, it's just tough because there were a lot of other people that were racing each other, which was slowing them down. I mean, once you get out there so far, it's kind of hard to catch the leader once they're out so far and you're still racing other people for position. So I don't know.
I mean, were you loose before you even made any adjustments, or did you just go too far?
I never had the chance to make any adjustments because once I got crashed, it was too late. And my first pit stop, I was already two laps down. I was so far off the pace that it was just there was no hope. And dinner was ready, so.
All right, I'll allow it.
Honestly, gotta get some food in me,
Dad.
Yeah. Yeah. I think given the choice between having the field dominated by AOS or getting food, I think I'll take food.
Yeah.
It looked like at certain points of the race, Mr. Bad Aim and Paco did have some decent speed. I don't know if you caught it.
Yeah, he was running in second. Mr. Bad Aim was. He's got some speed. I'll say that much. I mean. I think that if he could get close enough, he might be able to sniff a little bit of a draft and maybe get to him, but passing him is a whole different story, so.
Well, unfortunately, he clipped the cone and DC'd. And I think he's got caught up in a few incidents, but yeah. Looks like AOS is pretty much lapped the field here.
He already got the lead back on when Caddy pitted. Ooh, just, Paco giving Caddy a little bump down in turn one and two, a matter of fact. They're still magnetically right near each other. But the interval now is about... Well, let's see here. After that next round, second round of stops, AOS is at the line now, and Caddy's in the middle of one and two. So, a lap and three quarters now is the lead.
Almost two laps down.
I mean, I guess if somebody were to challenge him, like they would probably have to be on the same lap as him.
Yeah, that's kind of a prerequisite to being able to contend for a win.
Yeah.
Looks like we got about maybe 15 to 20 laps to go. I'm winding down here. But it's going to be...
I'm definitely... looking at it. It's, we're on lap 192 out of 200.
Yeah.
So he's got 8 to go. I joined the race, but I can't... I think that there might be a cap on how many people can spectate. Because it's not even giving me the option.
Well, let's see who gets a spirited battle, not for...
yeah, this isn't even... Caddy and Paco, this isn't even for position, because I think Paco's a couple laps down more than Caddy is.
Yeah, they've been running together all race. Paco's been a little fast, but on that last green flag stop, Caddy got back around. He's just got to clean up his mistakes. He's had a pretty damn fast car. He's just getting loose off two, or hitting the cone, or, you know, whatever.
And all that, and then just looking back from Caddy, and then I look back in the background, there's a yellow car just comes off turn four behind them. It's like, oh God, here he comes.
Yeah, Paco really trying, he's really entering high here, trying to get anything he can, but I don't think he has it.
When I had damage, that was one of the things that I started to do to gain a little bit of time or have a less slow lap. Got to really arc into the corner and then drive off, have a straight exit. That
maybe not arc in that much, though. Caddy just gave the bottom up to Paco. Completely missed one and two.
He might be able to clear here. He's not going to be able to clear. He's going to be about at the door, at the corner. Caddy might be able to come down into the corner, but no, he's going to stay on the top. Paco diving it down.
Gets a random again.
For the non-position...
Just in time to see Aos come roaring down the backstretch toward them.
Just in time to maybe stay only one lap down.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, Caddy better hurry, because...
The demoralizing race that Aos has put on here.
Yeah.
Even Duke Clayton, really bad race here, getting lapped again.
That's not good! Ooh, Aos cut him a break. Aos caught him a hell of a break there. He could have dumped him right there if he needed to. He got lucky on that one.
That could have been. Imagine he accidentally went down pit road speeding. Caddy might have been able to seal it.
What was more likely going to happen? Ooh, Aos, a little lag there. But what was more likely going to happen was that Caddy was going to get shot down like that, and Aos would have wrecked him. And for the second night in a row, Caddy would have gotten screwed out of second place. But instead, he has allowed the leader to go by. He is now two laps down, and now Aos is just going to eat up Paco, too.
Yeah, Paco, he's been...
Oh, and that's it. Aos wins it.
And that's the wall.
Well, that was a lag surge by the leader finishing the race. Oh, boy. And oh, boy. Lots of post-race lag on the 24 now.
And
he deserved it, though. He earned it.
No,
yeah, that'll do it for Richmond in the books. Been a pretty dominating race by AOS.
Yeah.
There are a few people that could have challenged him throughout the race, but all of them facing...
I would venture to say he probably got max points off of that. And if so, that means he got to within 6 points of you, King, but that was all he could do.
6 points too little.
It's at least going to make the standings look a lot closer than they actually had any rights to be.
Yeah, only running 8 races.
Yeah, and winning 7 of them.
Man, can you imagine being King?
Good lord, yeah.
AOS got a taste.
Fastest lap by just over a tenth, about a tenth and a quarter over Paco. Jeez, we had all kinds of freaking spectators. Look at that.
Yeah.
Who the hell are these two? All right.
Yeah, dude, why can't I replicate this success in your league? things never go my way.
Well, the difference is the setups.
Yeah, I think I guess I'm better with setups, yeah. Man.
All right, so
always get unlucky in your league.
Should we all jump back in and go haze Aos a bit, or...
Let's do it.
All right. I mean, I want to apologize, but, you know, I can't help it. I have a fast car.
I missed my setup big time.
I didn't even try.
It wasn't anything like I was practicing. I didn't really put a lot into it. I only had like an hour before the race.
I was put in King's shoes and it wasn't fun.
Yeah, you filled my shoes pretty good there. Someone had to do it.
Yeah, now I'm hated for it.
See, now you know how it feels. Now you know how it feels. Welcome to the club.
I wanted you to be in that race. And
then... Why? To absorb some of the hate?
Could have been your race, King.
Did y'all run out of things to say?
Oh, yeah.
We try to keep it going. We did as well as we could hope.
We ended up bringing Duke. We ended up bringing Duke Jr. in to do an interview because it was.
Yeah. We had him come on. You know, take the last 30 laps.
Hey, did you guys like pretend like who was leading and just go with whatever battles were happening?
Yeah. Like,
spur position.
Yeah, we ended up fixating on Caddy and Paco. Those two just wouldn't get away from each other.
They were together the most.
Yeah, it wasn't for position. We knew that. But, I mean, it was a spirited battle nonetheless.
Yeah. That was the highlight of the race.
No, but AOS, it looks like Bad Aim had a pretty good car to challenge you, but he had a few issues at the con.
Yeah, he hit the pit road, I heard.
Yeah. Pretty unfortunate there. At least on that last restart, he kept with you pretty good until he made a few mistakes and then hit the cone.
Yeah. Well, there goes Bad Aim's race.
So, Alois, who you want to thank? Come on.
Thank Lucas Cram for forcing me to have this set up so I could beat him at Richmond, knowing that later I'd be using it to win this race.
Yeah, Lucas, he's pretty good. He'll challenge you to do better for sure.
Yeah, setups are setups. You still gotta be able to drive it.
Yep.
Apparently I wish I could have wrecked some cars, but you know, yeah. Get everything you want.
He at the end there.
Like the guys that stay out of the way.
Yeah, AOS, at the end there, you almost got caught up with something and pushed onto pit road like the last.
Talking about that. Yeah, that would have disqualified me because it was less than two to go.
Yeah.
Caddy would have won the race.
That doesn't count at the end of the race.
No, yeah. I don't think it does. Does it?
Yeah.
Because who would?
Well, say if you're out of fuel and you just go to pit road to kind of pull you along.
There's no gain. It's the end of the race.
Well, there is a gain. Like, say if you're out of fuel and you can't make it to the line, you have to go on pit road to actually get
speed.
Yeah,
but we do it at the end of the segment, so we get a lap pass.
Yeah,
you don't get a pass
at the end
of the race.
At the end of the race, though.
So there's no penalty on the last two laps of the actual race.
Well, the actual race has to be, like, the last lap. Because, I mean, you could technically pass someone in the pits.
Take a hell of a lot doing.
But then also, yeah, I guess thinking that if there was a wreck too, then it'd be... Caddy would have the free pass. He would have been... at the back of the pack behind all the other cars, and he'd have to come through all of that and then pass me.
It's too much.
And everyone would just let him by. It's like, they gotta beat me for it, I'm sure.
It's just too much to think about. But I did save that setup he put up there. I'll work on it.
Yeah. Well, Amp, thank you for having me. It was fun.
Oh, slightly. It made it slightly less boring than it would have another one.
Yeah, it was fun.
What's the second setup?
Maybe if I win every race next season, we can do it again.
All right, you just start with the first race.
Yeah, start with Talladega and see how you do there.
Yeah, that'll make it interesting, yeah. Yeah, I missed the first race in every series.
Well, I was saying that...